You know, the American people this year ought to be on their knees right now, thanking Almighty God for all the tremendous and glorious blessings that we've received during the past year. I have a verse to give to the American people from the Bible. I want to read it to you. Here it is. Luke, the 12th chapter and the 48th verse. Unto whomsoever much is given, of him shall be much required. These are the words of Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ said, to whom much is given, much is required. I heard about a plane that nearly crashed the other day, an airliner. And as the plane was going down, the pilot maneuvered it in such a way that the plane landed safely. And there was one very wealthy man on board that a few days later sent the pilot a check for $5,000. He said, I want to repay you because my heart is thankful for saving my life. The pilot refused the check. But you know, God has done far more for us than any pilot has ever done. Because God has given to the American people more blessing than we have ever had in our history. And I wonder if we think to thank God. Remember the 10 lepers that came to Jesus Christ? 10 lepers came to Christ and he healed them all. But only one came back and said that he was thankful. We have much to be thankful for. The clothes that we wear, the food that we eat, the shelter over our head. All of that comes from God because the Bible says every good and perfect gift cometh from God. It's all a provision of his hands. And the Bible says the goodness of God leads to repentance. As a result of the mighty goodness of God, instead of going to the nightclubs and the brothels, instead of going to all of these places of wickedness, Americans ought to be on their knees thanking God. No other nation in the world has the spiritual and religious freedoms that Americans have. I'm thankful for that, to worship God according to the dictates of my conscience. I may be Catholic or Protestant or Jew. What difference does it make? I have the right to worship God the way I want to worship him. I thank God for the freedom we have of preaching the gospel. Did you know there's no other nation in the world that you can preach the Christ on television as in America? There's no other place in the world that you can preach Christ on radio as you can in America. There's no other place in the world that we have the freedom of the press that we have in America to give the gospel by the press to the American people. I thank God this year for all that God has poured out upon us. I wonder if you've stopped to thank God for the blessings you have. I wonder if you've stopped to thank God that you're just existing, that you're just living this year. There are many people that died during the past year. There are many people in hospitals, and you're not. Many people on crutches, and you may not be. You have 1,000 things to thank God for this Thanksgiving. It all came from him. And then Jesus said, to whom much is given, much is required. God, first of all, requires repentance of sin. Have you repented of your many sins? Have you turned from your sins? To whom much is given, much is required. Did you know God requires more of us than he does Russia? God requires more of us than he does Sodom and Gomorrah. We've had more chance. We've had more opportunity than any nation in all the world. And God requires more of us as American people. God requires first that you repent of your sin. Secondly, he requires that we have a righteous nation because righteousness exalteth any nation. And then thirdly, God requires personal faith in his son, Jesus Christ. God requires that. He's given us much. All of these blessings and these bounties that have come our way this year should drive you right now to your knees in prayer, thanking God and accepting his son, Jesus Christ, which is the greatest gift of his love. Will you accept him? Will you trust him? Will you take him into your heart right now? If you will, I want you to bow your head. Pray with me. I'm going to pray for you right now. Shall we pray? Our Father and our God, we're deeply grateful and thankful to thee for all of the blessings that we've received during the past year. But most of all, we thank thee for the great gift of salvation that is in thy Son, Jesus Christ. And we pray that just now, many shall accept the gift of thy love by saying yes to Jesus Christ. For we ask it in his name. Amen.